Southern America, especially in Colombia. So since then, a bill of 10,000 pesos is not circulated anymore because it was replaced by another lady, Dr. Gutierrez, an anthropologist. And so this is a kind of characteristic of the bill appears right here, and the safety features too. So it's basically to educate the people in regards to the new design of paper money, in this case from Colombia. But for example, central banks in Venezuela produce this kind of material. This is the same banknotes of where appears Luisa Cáceres de Ligeti. So they go, for example, to the schools or to the university or colleges to explain about this new currency and about the design of the engine. In this case, the Venezuela decided to put some animals who are in extinction. In this case, some turtles from Margarita Island. So, so this is basically the material that is produced for different countries in Latin America to inform or to educate the children about the new products. In the year 2000, I had the opportunity to participate in a project with the Latin American Union in Durham, producing 20 posters about the currency units in front of America. So this is an article from the Telson in the year 2000, and there are some posters were exhibited in each branch of the Latin American Union, and it is this section in Spanish and in English, and they the ministry. Okay?
¿Ese libro que
tiene,
ese lo
que
vende o
lo pueden leer? Sí, en la página que te mostré se puede adquirir a través de una biblioteca o una librería virtual que tiene Rafael. A través de ese link, wordpalabras.com, yo estoy en la sección de historia. Y aparece entonces la versión tanto en inglés como en español de este libro que fue publicado originalmente en 2007 y la versión en español salió en 2009. Entonces, como te digo, trae una biografía de Luisa Cáceres de Ligeti y como Francisco Aguilar.
En inglés.
Ok. Through this website, wordpalabras.com, you can find information about this book entitled Simon Bolivar in the United States. You can find both versions in English and Spanish. And there is a brief bio of this lady, Luisa Cáceres de Ligeti, and of course about another heroes of the Latin American Revolution, Simon Bolivar and Francisco de Miguel.
People, they would also donate a lot of the books to her collection.
And because she was protected by, like you said, the...
And these are royal, right. New Mexico.
Right. They said that she had an amorous relationship with the vicar, I mean, with the...
The wife.
So when the bishop requested that she turn over all her books, she did what she had the help of her nuns, of her sisters, to translate most of those books and then sent them through a friend back to Spain, and then El Virrey, La Virreina. She got them published.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because remember, most of those books were printed in Spain, right. Not in the New World.
That comes my next
question.
The second question. Voy a pasar a español. ¿Qué tanta restricción tenía ella en el tipo de libros que podía adquirir? Porque ya sabes que aún, inclusive hoy en día, en muchas universidades en Sudamérica, sí, mm-hmm. especialmente si son católicas, restringen el tipo de libros que
pueden adquirir. Yo lo que te decía, en la época que ella vivió, existió la situación de la Inquisición en Europa y especialmente en España, por la religión católica. Entonces, desafortunadamente, muchas de sus obras podían, o muchos de estos libros podían llegar a ser quemados, porque era lo que hacían, sacaban los libros y los quemaban en la vía pública. Entonces, ella, viendo que eso iba a pasar con su biblioteca personal, su biblioteca privada, entonces ella prefería venderlos para ayudar a la gente pobre.
Y después
de todavía sigue siendo monja, esa vocación de servicio, pero desafortunadamente ella muere también porque se contagia de una enfermedad de la persona que ella cuidaba y fallece pues desafortunadamente en México, y, pero sus obras, las que logró publicar, pues todavía trascendieron en España, porque tenían copias en España.
Yes. So yeah, so like what he was saying, most of the books that she had that were forbidden, the church would keep copies of them, and they were put in a specific place in the library, and she would not have access to them. But because she was in good standings with those that kept the library, they would give her access to those books, and she would be able to read a lot of the books that maybe were considered, books that the church said that they shouldn't read. And by certain authors, but this was well known. I mean, even if you read El Quijote, Cervantes, there's a selection of books that he makes reference to that were set aside as forbidden books. But you would see that the actual priest, as they were selecting the books in the Quijote to burn, they would say, "Oh yeah, well we got to burn, but no, this one we're going to keep because of this." So those books were there, were made available, but they were hidden. So only a few people would have access to them. But yeah.
And what is the time period of her life?
1653 to
1695. 1651 to 1695.
Right.
And this almost the same time that Miguel de Cervantes, who wrote the Quijote, is a masterpiece of the Spanish literature.
Con respecto a lo que preguntaba, es interesante destacar que el tipo de la manera que ella redactaba, la manera que ella escribía también, no solamente fue una persona, digamos, preparada dentro del mundo del clero, ¿no? Como monja, para servir, para tener lo que llaman la vocación de servicio, sino también ella se convirtió como un tipo de activista para la mujer de la época.